Nick Markakis is back.
Breaking news right now. Braves veteran outfielder Nick Markakis has decided to opt back, not out, back in to playing the 2020 season.
The Atlanta Braves outfielder is rejoining the team after opting out of the 2020 season just over 3 weeks ago. Okay, so I was under the assumption that once you opted out, you couldn't change your mind. But it turns out under MLB rules, a player can come back from the restricted list if an application is submitted for reinstatement prior to August 1st. So yeah, I didn't know that. Markakis changed his mind following his initial decision to sit out over health concerns. He made the decision after a conversation with teammate Freddie Freeman, who contracted COVID-19 and experienced symptoms such as high fever. Markakis went on to say, "I'm going against my previous decision," according to Gabe Burns of the Atlanta Journal. "I'd like to come back. In the pit of my stomach, I felt like I needed to be out there. It's been in my blood since 4 years old," the former All-Star said. "And it sucks watching baseball when you know you can still go out there and compete and play on a daily basis, and it eats away at you a little bit." Of the 14 major leaguers who opted out, Markakis is the first to return. This is such a unique situation because obviously Yasiel Puig was signed and then he came down with COVID. So, you know, the Braves got out of that, which now opens up for Markakis to return. I wonder if, you know, Puig had worked out, if Markakis still would have contemplated coming back. But either way, if you're a Braves fan, you have to be ecstatic about this. A huge piece of that team will be returning. Staying in the MLB with more news, Joe Kelly has been suspended 8 games by the Major League Baseball for his role in the benches clearing incident that occurred at Minute Maid Park in Houston on Tuesday night. Dodgers manager Dave Roberts was issued a 1-game suspension, and Houston Astros manager Dusty Baker was fined an undisclosed amount, MLB announced on Wednesday afternoon. Kelly, who threw a fastball behind Alex Bregman's head and later taunted Carlos Correa on the way back to the dugout, will appeal his suspension. 8 games. Under a 60-game format, an 8-game suspension accounts for more than 13% of the schedule. Let me remind you that Joe Kelly got a 6-game suspension in a 162-game season for actually hitting Tyler Austin with a fastball and fighting him. How the F did he get an 8 games in a 60-game season for missing Carlos Correa with a curveball and mocking him for being a crybaby? He didn't even get ejected.
Slams the bat, now he's making a move, and here he comes, on the run, and now fisticuff.
Kelly went on to deny the intent after the Dodgers 5-2 win, saying, "My accuracy isn't the best." Do I believe Joe Kelly's pitches were intentional? 100%. But an 8-game suspension is a bit harsh in my eyes when you think about the fact that it's equivalent to a 22-game suspension in a normal 162-game season.